Prince Valiant Lives. The adventures of the legendary character from Harold Foster's comic strip are perfect for the movies. A wonderful balance between realism and fantasy. Young Valiant fears no opponent and rises to every challenge. He undertakes innumerable adventures to recover Excalibur from the Vikings, and not only wins the Wild Princess Eileen, but also saves Camelot, King Arthur's kingdom. Besides spine-tingling action and fantasy, the atmosphere of Foster's famous comic strip is reinforced by animated cartoon sequences in the style of the original.
Action! Come on, guys!
It's directed by action specialist Anthony Hickox, who made use of almost the full repertoire of tricks, stunts, and special effects while shooting in Wales and in the Babelsberg Studios. Hickox himself played the part of Sir Gawain, and Stephen Moyer made his film debut as Prince Valiant.
I laughed at the audition. I was so taken in by the series of events, which I won't go into now, that I was just at the end of it, I was just giggling. And because I was giggling, when I actually got in front of camera, I kind of wasn't taking it very seriously. And I think he kind of quite liked that.
But Stephen soon stopped laughing when they got to the set.
That wasn't much fun, actually, because I got on a 2.5 mil line, and I was hanging from somewhere, not unlike that kind of top thing up there. I don't know, I said it was 100 feet, but the stuntmen said it was 50.
Michael Wayne, well known for his bungee jump in GoldenEye, was the stunt coordinator. That meant he had to be both a safety expert and an armed combat instructor.
We try and involve Stephen as much as possible, but there just comes a time, and you really make a judgment, you know, on the floor when the decision is made that no, this is unacceptable for him to take a particular risk. And it's really a judgment you make over years of experience, you know when to draw the line.
The numerous stunts were also a new experience for Catherine Hagel, who played Princess Eileen.
I think the challenges of this role consist mainly of the stunts that need to be performed and the fact that she does have all this hair down all the time and these long dresses. It's hard to kind of perform on horses and with swords and in freezing rain in this outfit. I think that's probably the most challenging part of it.
I'm Princess Eileen of Brenwyn.
And of course she gets into some sticky situations in the film, such as the harem of Thangar the Viking.
I am Monday.
I am Tuesday.
I am Wednesday.
And you're Thursday.
That's today.
Filming in Wales meant coping with the weather. It rained almost every day.
The most dispiriting thing has been that every costume that we send out has been almost destroyed immediately by the weather. Sorry, Wales.
Change of scene to the castle of Sligon, King of the Vikings. He got his men to steal Excalibur so that he would have power over Camelot. The crew was glad to move to the warm, dry studios in Babelsberg for the interior shots. Here they set up the domain of the power-crazed Sligon, portrayed by Udo Kier. Thomas Kretschmann played his decadent brother, Thagnar.
You're still alive. Thank you for your concern, dear brother. Excalibur, now the world is mine.
Sligon has the power. He's the king of the Vikings, and I'm his brother who bumps him off to succeed to his throne.
Räum ihn aus dem Weg, um selber der King zu sein,
He's a bit of a megalomaniac, the character I play, I mean. Something like a little Mussolini. The brothers are aided by Joanna Lumley as Morgan Le Fay.
She became evil, I can't think where in her lifetime. And she left Britain, and she sided with the Vikings, the kings of Thule. And she can cast spells, she can fly, she can turn cats into pigs, she can hex people. She has dust to make people sleep. She's wonderful.
Several members of Hell's Angels were recruited as Vikings. They obviously felt at home in the costumes designed by Lindy Hemming.
I think that he just wants the film to be accessible to young people, even though it's about knights and ladies. He wants them to look and think, oh wow, that looks great, or God, did you see that? You know, he doesn't want people dressed in a way that would put people off.
Producer Bernd Eichinger reawakens Prince Valiant to new life in a fantastic adventure full of action, suspense, and magic.